Hi there, I'm Patrick Fulton, assistant professor in Earth and Atmospheric Sciences here at Cornell. And here we're in my lab in Sydney Hall. And around me, we have all these blue boxes filled with drill cuttings. We've drilled through all of our major targets in our borehole at this point in time. We are down in the deep crystalline rocks underneath the sedimentary rocks right now. And we're all getting ready and set to do our logging and testing program. We're really excited about this next phase because the last thing that we do is a hydrologic test. That's really important because that's really kind of one of the big targets of this whole project, trying to figure out, is there zones underground where we can actually flow water through existing fracture networks or existing permeable zones, so that when we perhaps later have an injection well and producing well, we know exactly where there is a permeable spot where we can inject water, allow it to flow through that zone, collect heat, and then allow us to pull it out from the other well. When we do this test, we'll also collect a little bit of that water, about 300 gallons, about the size of a hot tub. It's going to be a little bit warm as well. So we'll filter it, all that water, to try to collect what few microbes or a few cells might be living underneath there. If they live down there, how do they live? What does their DNA look like? How have they evolved over time to be able to live down there? And what do they eat? These types of questions are the same type of questions that our friends and colleagues studying life on other planets, if it's out there, are really interested in as well. Because if there is life on other planets, many people think that it might also live underground in briny, salty waters, and perhaps an extreme environment very similar to what we have here at CUBO. So we're all real excited to get to the end of this stage of the project. This is the time when all the real kind of best and most exciting science is going to be collected, and then we'll analyze it for a long period of time afterwards.